Let's start the assembly of two cylinder engine in SolidWorks. Select here new assembly. Okay, that's it. Now let's browse our first part, engine block. Okay, now this is the SolidWorks assembly window. Let's let's browse our new part, crankshaft. Select this crankshaft, edit, and here we want to make some holes, so select this face, sketch, center line, corner rectangle, now let's define it. This is just for the, it will create a 0.5 millimeter. Okay, now select extruded cut, make 0.1 millimeter depth, that's it. Now save it, cancel, save in assembly. Now let's make insert, select this hole and choose mat, concentric relation. Okay, select this face and this face and choose here distance 2.6 millimeter. Okay, that's it. Now press control key and copy, just rotate this, it should be like this, and make it opposite to this. Okay, choose mat, select this circular face and this circular face, concentric relation. Okay, now select this, see this is the main use, select this side wall and select this side wall and make relation parallel. Okay, now both are parallel together. Now drag it out. Now select this inside face and this face, coincident relation. Okay, now here, now let's rotate, see both rotating in opposite direction. Let's take this position. Now let's bring our next part, sprocket, large icon, so crankshaft sprocket, choose here mat, both the circular faces and concentric relation, select this face and this face, coincident relation. Now select this slot side wall and this pin side wall and make relation parallel. Okay, cancel it. Now let's try to rotate, see this is rotating in a beautiful way. Let's back come back side. And now here we will fix our next part. So let's insert, browse, camshaft with sprocket. Now rotate the camshaft, rotate component. Okay, choose here mat, select this inside hole and camshaft circular face, concentric relation. Okay, now here also select this face and this face, and here select distance 2.6 millimeter. Okay, okay, that's it. Okay, that's fine. Our gear is going to mat here anyways. Okay, because this position should be in perfect place. We would like to edit this face, so do one thing, evaluate, measure, select these two faces. And just find out the distance. Blue 0.88. Cancel it. Now edit this feature. Extruded boss. This one 6.8. Make it minus 0.88. Okay. Okay, it's already minus. Cancel, save. That's it. Now see, it's going to match here. That's perfect. Now it's time to add some gear relation. Go to assembly, mat, and go to mechanical mat, choose gear. Now first select this corner edge and this corner edge. This is by default selected, so we will keep this as it is. We will not do anything else. Okay, okay. Now let's try. See, it is rotating along with same crank. Let's browse our next part, push rod. We need two number of push rods, so rotate. Okay, now choose here mat, select this hole and this arbor, this push rod. Concentric relation, here also the same thing, concentric relation. Now here we want to make cam and shaft relation, so we have to do one thing. For cam relation there is two faces, we want to make one face. I forget during this sketch, so we will make it one face. So edit, select this face, sketch. Now go to insert, tools, and here you will find spline tools, fit spline. Select both these splines, zero, it is automatically selected, okay. Now see, it is become one geometry. Exit, see, the whole face become one geometry. The C in the second one, there is two face, so edit, go to menus, tools, spline, fit geometry. Select these two splines, constraint geometry, okay. Exit. Now you will see here it is single faces. Now it is easy for the cam rotation or cam relation. Now cancel from here, it is asking to save, select yes, select here also yes. Now we will see take it up, go to mat and go to mechanical mat, choose here cam. Now select here path, see this cam face we selected, and here select cam follower. So select this face, see it's met here, tangent relation, okay. Second one and this one met, cancel. Let's check what last met we did. Edit, reverse, that's it, okay. Now again choose cam, this is the path and this body, okay. Now cancel it, just rotate this, this is also come down, cam to re-edit, mat alignment reverse, okay, okay. Now see this cam rotation, this is what we want, we want to, that's it. Now let's insert our other parts. Select arbor, choose mat, select this and hole, concentric relation, okay. Now select these two faces, make the gap 0.15, okay. Now let's see whether it's really, no, because this is our hole and it is not matching. So what we will do, delete, concentric, reverse, okay. Now drag it here, now try this face and this face, gap 0.15 millimeter. Okay, now let's see, that's looking perfect. Insert. Now let's bring here rocker arm, we need two number of rocker arms, so rotate this rocker arm. Okay, now let's make relation met. Select this hole and this arbor, concentric relation. Okay, this side wall, arbor and rocker arm, coincident relation. Okay, select this face and this, make relation tangent. Okay, see, circle and this arbor, concentric relation. Select this face and this face, coincident relation. That's it. This circle and this face, tangent relation. Okay, okay. Now the arbor arm with rocker arm fixed here. If you will rotate, see, both going to be rotated. Now what else balance? Let's see. Okay, choose connecting rod. Press control key and make one more. First take it out, this one met. Coincident relation, concentric relation, this face and this face. Okay, now let's browse our other, this face and this circle, concentric relation. Now select this side wall and this side wall. Okay, now it's fixed here. Insert. Now choose piston and pin together, open. Now here we will make some relations met. Select this pin and this hole, concentric relation. Okay, advanced met, width met. Select these two faces, come inside, select these two faces. Okay, okay. Now met, select this face and this face, make concentric relation. Okay, select this circle, pin and connecting rod, concentric relation. Okay, now let's move it. Okay, now press control key and browse one more pin met. Select the hole and pin and make relation concentric. Now again advanced met, width. Select this face of both side face of pin and both side wall of piston. Okay, select this face and met this face. See here, concentric relation created, connecting rod and pin, concentric relation. Okay, okay. Now let's see how our engine works. see. Just select this pin, star point and hide it. We have here, okay, all the star point hides. Now I think some more parts are balanced. Browse, valve. Press control key and bring one more valve. Let's check whether, okay, we need two valves, so that's fine. Mat, select this face and this inside face, make relation co-centric. That's it. This face and this face, create tangent relation, cancel it. Let's try mat, try cam and camshaft relation. I think not need. It's not taking the, okay, this wall tangent relation. Okay, that's it. Now other select this hole and this wall, co-centric relation. Okay, select this face and this top face, tangent relation. Okay, now let's see how the wall works. See this wall, if it's going to rotate, see wall open and close. So this is the our total assembly of we will see this way is looking better. Enlarge, that's it. Now let's save the assembly. Refresh it, save all. Now here select two cylinder engine assembly, save. Right click, go to motion manager, motion study, open. First select motion analysis. Here select 50 frame per second. Motor. Select this face. Make it reverse. RPM. Okay, now select here calculate. Now it is going to calculate slowly. This rotation is too slow, so we will do one thing. We will just increase the speed of rotation. Play. That's fine. That's fine. Now save this animation. Choose your destination, desktop, anywhere, AVI file, and I'll choose ratio 16:9, 50 frames, save, uncheck, OK. Now it is again is going to calculate from the start and it's going to save in your system or in your destination. I hope you like it. This is the simple two cylinder engine for the beginners or for the newcomers who want to learn the SolidWorks. I hope this will help to those people. Please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comments, please write down in comment section. I'll try to answer each and every question. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.